So, you're new to Rocket League and want to get better? Well, then you've come to the right place. First, I'm not an absolutely amazing player. I'm champ 1 in 3v3 standard, but I do have a good idea of what I will be talking about in this guide series, and I have a lot to offer to new players or anyone that is stuck in trying to get out of the bronze to low diamond ranks. In part 1 of this series, we'll be going over the custom option settings, most importantly gameplay, camera, and controls, that will give you an advantage over players using just the default settings. And I know this seems kind of boring, but it's actually very important and can make a huge difference in the long run. Since changing some of these option settings once you've grown used to the default ones can mess with your ability to play well, I definitely recommend that all new players take the time to optimize their option settings before putting in hours of training with the subpar standard settings. Also, a lot of the settings that I'll cover will directly improve your gameplay, but I'll also cover some settings that you can customize to your liking for an overall improvement to the gameplay experience. Okay, let's get started. The first of these options is in the gameplay category, and for text and voice chat, if you won't be using a mic and don't want to hear the other people talking over the game, just turn voice chat off. For text chat, if you can handle trash talk from the enemy team and don't feel like it affects your performance, you can leave it set to allow all. But personally, I like to have it set to team only, as when I'm having a rough game, the last thing I need to deal with is toxicity from the enemy team. I have crossplay enabled as it allows for faster queue times, and there isn't a super noticeable advantage for players on PC in this game. Some people like to have crossplay turned off, and this game actually gives you the option to do so. The only thing is that you won't be able to enter tournaments unless you have crossplay enabled. Also, I like to have the game stat display level set to all stats, as it'll then show you when you've cleared the ball or centered it and earned points for those sorts of things, as well as the goals and saves, etc. Now we can move on to the camera options, and these are really important, so make sure that if you take nothing else away from this video that you turn off camera shake. It basically makes the game unplayable in my opinion, and you'll notice that literally no player above plat has it enabled. For some reason, it's enabled by default, so yeah, make sure to turn that off. I like to have my field of view all the way up so I can see more of the field, and everything else in my settings is sort of optional and you can tune it to your liking, but I've set mine based on the settings of some pro players, so make of that what you will. Now we're on to the control options, and this is where the video might get a bit controversial, so personally I like to have the vibration for the haptic feedback it gives when using things like boost or for indicating how well you connected with the ball. My controller dead zone is set to 0.1, but it all depends on how susceptible your controller is to drift. If you find yourself turning or slowly drifting in a certain direction when you're not even moving the left stick, you may want to increase your dead zone a bit. That being said, the lower you can set your dead zone without experiencing any drift, the more finely you'll be able to control the movement of your car. Dodge dead zone is something different altogether and is actually very important. For those of you who don't know what dodging is, when you jump in the air, you can hold the left stick in a given direction and tap the jump button again to dodge in that direction. If you don't have the left stick pointed in any direction and press the jump button a second time in the air, you'll simply double jump, gaining an extra vertical boost. And as a quick side note, you can only double jump or perform a dodge a short time after first taking off from the ground. From my experience, it's about 2 seconds. Now back to the dodge dead zone, that determines how far you have to push the stick in any direction to perform a dodge instead of a double jump. The greater the dodge dead zone, the further you will need to push the stick in any direction to initiate a dodge instead of a double jump. To put this in more helpful terms, if you find yourself constantly flipping when you want to perform a double jump, you might want to increase your dodge dead zone a bit. On the other hand, if you find yourself struggling to flip in a direction when you want to, and so you just double jump instead, you might want to decrease the dodge dead zone. For me, I personally like to have it at 0.85, which allows me to dodge when I intend to, but also allows me to more reliably double jump when I need to quickly ascend for an aerial. I've seen players in the champ to grand champ ranks have their dodge dead zone set as low as 0.65 and as high as 1.0. Now let's talk about button bindings, and I personally am on an Xbox controller, so I mostly leave everything as default. The only thing I changed and that I recommend you change is the air roll button. Instead of the air roll being toggled with holding down the left bumper, I like to turn that off altogether and instead use the air roll left and air roll right buttons on the left and right bumpers. These will automatically make your car roll to the left or right when you hold down on the left or right bumpers, and will allow you to retain directional control with the left stick while in the air. This makes it much easier to perform fancy maneuvers in the air and greatly expands aerial control. And this is one of those changes that can be difficult to get used to if you've already been playing with just the default air roll button for a long time, but if you're a new player, it really won't matter that much or affect you that much, and in the long run, it'll make you a much better player. And I'm not sure if it matters, but I also like to have the scoreboard set to the menu button, the small button left of the home button, and I like to have the text chat mapped to the start button, which is the small button right of the home button. For anyone that's interested, I have an explanation on why I do that in the video description, but for the sake of time, let's move on to the interface options. So here are my interface settings, which I don't think I messed with too much, but if yours are different and you want to copy mine, you can go ahead and pause the video now. And here are my video settings, and basically I turn off the extra special effects and light shafts and all that, just because while they look nice, they are a bit distracting, and I prefer to play without them. Alright, here are my audio settings, and these mostly depend on personal preference, but I like to turn off the music, ambient, and crowd sounds, just because it allows me to focus on the all-important gameplay sounds, like hearing opponents or teammates that are approaching while outside of your visual field, and if you want to have Rocket League's music tracks playing while in-game, you can enable that here too. And while I'm on the subject, you can enable or disable specific soundtracks by holding down the right stick click while in the main lobby, at least that's how you do it on Xbox, and you can skip songs by just clicking the right stick click, either in the main lobby or also in a game or match by performing the same actions with the start menu pulled up. And mostly just for fun, here are my different quick chat choices. Again, these are largely personal preference. An important note is that the information quick chats will only be visible to teammates, even if you have allow all for the text chat settings in the gameplay tab. So it's good to put quick chats here that you want your teammates to see, but not your opponents, such as need boost or I got it, and so on. And finally, there's the extras tab, which is not super important unless you're trying to redeem a code, get support, enable parental controls, manage account linking, or anything of the like. And that should do it for part 1 of this beginner's guide series to Rocket League. Be on the lookout for the next video where I'll go over how to make the best use of free play and also the custom training packs that I like to use in order to improve on all sorts of essential mechanics. If you want to see more great content, I'll leave a few good videos at the end of this video, or you can head over to my channel where all those videos are hanging out. And if you're new, consider subscribing. You're helping me feed my cat, her name's Marshmallow. Have a great day. If you're here today, have a great Tuesday. And as always, thanks for watching.